Hello, welcome back to my project, this is Eric. In the previous video, we were able to confirm that ESP32 works properly using the basic functions of OpenCV. From this video, we will take a look at what projects we can work on and complete with this one by one. The application you see on the screen right now is quite interesting. The two functions are working together. First of all, it's the histogram that covers the entire screen. The histogram is a graphical representation of the brightness distribution in an image. It's widely used for image analysis. The second working function is to get the RGB code value. The RGB values are obtained from the pixel in the center of the image, and information about this is displayed at the top of the screen. All of this is calculated using OpenCV inside ESP32. Pretty cool, isn't it? For the color detection test, three colors were prepared using color dyes on the 96-watt plate. The color gets brighter as you go from left to right. Even though I can get perfectly linear values, I can get approximate color information. In fact, in order to do this experiment properly, I had to prepare the uniform lighting first, but I couldn't. It can be simple, but still exciting and practical. This is the kind of project I want to do. Let's take a look at the overall configuration of the system together. This source code can be found in my GitHub repository. You can find the link in the video description below. First, let's talk about the system in general. This project is built on ESP-IDF framework. Platform.io also supports ESP-IDF framework, so you can use it. However, the code needs to be rewritten to work in Arduino IDE. ESP32 camera component is added here. Here, you can edit all of the camera's information like image resolution, hardware connected pins, X clock speed, and image types like JPEG, grayscale, and RGB565. Next is the graphics library. It's using the Adafruit GFX library as a graphic driver to draw the screen. Also, all information that appears on the screen is drawn using LVGL. The version of LVGL used here is 7 and is old. I have a plan to upgrade to the latest version LVGL 8 in the near future. And then finally, it's added as an external library of OpenCV. It's possible to capture an image and display it on the screen without OpenCV. But we need to use OpenCV to make the project we want. Currently, the only libraries available are core functionality, image processing, and image file reading and writing. It contains only the core features of OpenCV. Although it would be nice to use more libraries, they will be over spec. For simple projects, this may be enough. Today's project was created based on this. This application acquires an image from the camera and updates the screen after getting center pixel information and a histogram of the entire image through OpenCV. The RGB pixel detector gets the pixel information of the center of the image and updates the screen with the LVGL bar widget. The function of the histogram drawer obtains the histogram information from the entire RGB565 image obtained from the camera and draws it again on the source image. That way you get an overlaid image. This is an OpenCV application for ESP32 that I made. OpenCV has a long history. There are lots of really good tutorials. If you want to know more about image processing, please take a look at them. It's gonna be way too better than me. Let me build and flash it to my device. To build this, follow the same method as shown in the previous video. I will also try to upgrade this to the latest version of IDF. Oh, no code changed from the previous build, so it's done right away. All looks good. Let me flash and test it. The incoming image and histogram graph are merged and displayed on the screen. Also, at the top of the screen, the pixel in the center of the incoming image is analyzed and displayed as RGB values. It works fine. Since the black object is close to zero in RGB, you can clearly see that there are changes. Depending on the incoming image, everything is calculated and displayed on the screen in real time. For reference, the screen is updated at around 4 FPS. We will have to think about it how we can upgrade little by little. In order to identify objects by color, the HSV model performs better than the RGB model. A color recognition project would also be interesting. I'll do it when I get a chance. Today's video ends here. Hopefully you guys found this video useful. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.